Sometimes Japanese grammar is gonna feel like this.
Yeah, だからさ、そういうわけじゃないと言ってないけど、そんなことなくない？
あ、あの、うん、うん、なくない？
え、特にそんなこと思ってんの？
変態、最低、
本当？最低、変態。
But I'm gonna show you how to master it.One of the first hurdles of learning Japanese is that the sentences are usually written backwards from English. English uses the SVO sentence structure, or subject verb object. For example, I eat sushi. However, Japanese uses SOV sentence structure, or subject object verb. So in Japanese, you would say,
私は寿司を食べます.
Which would literally translate to I sushi eat. And if you're wondering what these letters in white are, these are called particles.And they will ruin your life. Particles are typically placed after a word and describe how this word interacts with the rest of the sentence. For example, the particle wo means that the word before it is having an action done to it, such as this sushi is being eaten. The particle ni can mark a destination, such as I will go to Japan. Now, this is all fine and nice, but there are so many particles, and sometimes it'll get really obscure as to which particle you should be using. And if you try to ask a native Japanese speaker to explain it, you'll always be met with the same answer.
わかんないな。直感かな？
うん、そうだね。直感だと思う。
What I've learned is that particles are as much of an art as they are a science. Meaning that there are rules that will explain their usage, but ultimately you'll just have to speak and listen to enough Japanese to get a feel for them and acquire this elusive 直感. Other aspects of Japanese grammar can seem confusing as well. For example, to say, you must eat this, you would say, これを食べなくてはいけません. Or literally, if you don't eat this, it cannot go. I don't know what this it is and why we need to care about it going or not, don't stop it from going.Or there will be consequences. Enough talk about why Japanese grammar sucks. Let's talk about how to overcome it and why it can actually be kind of dope once you've mastered it. Textbooks are great resources because they're typically well-structured. I've heard nothing but good things about the Genki series, so this could be a great place for you to start. But when I started out, I was a broke 18-year-old who didn't want to spend no $60 on a textbook. So I scrounged the internet for free resources and found Tae Kim's Guide to Japanese Grammar. Tae Kim's Guide is awesome because like a textbook, it teaches the grammar in a logical sequence and does a great job of explaining whenTo use a certain grammar and why. And it's free. The website also allows you to hover your mouse over the kanji to reveal the reading, so you can practice reading real Japanese sentences while not being held back by kanji.
And it's free.
Another resource I love to use is called Japanese Test for You. This one's more of a complete list of all the grammar from N5 all the way up to N1, with example sentences and practice tests you can take. This site was great for cramming all the grammar the day before the JLVT exam,
which I did not do.
When you're starting out, it can feel a bit confusing as to where to start and how to progress. So I recommend following Tae Kim's Guide or a textbook on a regular basis, and then using sites like Japanese Test for You or even YouTube as bonus learning materials. And I'll link all the resources down below, except for YouTube. I think you can find that one. And in terms of actually learning new grammar, here's one of the biggest pieces of advice I can give. Before you try to just memorize a grammar point, try to see if there's a logic behind it, because this will make it a lot easier to remember. For example, the grammar のように is used to liken two things.
彼は太陽のように輝いた.
Which means he shined bright like the sun. Now you could be a fool like I was and just try to memorize it.
Or if you were truly galaxy brain,
you would notice that the yo in this grammar is the yo that means appearance. So this grammar is literally saying to do something in the appearance of something else, which makes sense. This technique will make you twice as fast at picking up new grammar. But once you've learned a new grammar point, it's gonna take some time before you can actually pick it up when it's spoken to you. For example,with the double negative, nakunai? Instead of calculating the number of negatives there are and trying to find the answer like it's some sort of math test, I've just associated that sound,
nakunai,
with the speaker looking to confirm that something is not the case. Once you've found the logic behind a new grammar point and heard it enough times, it should look a little something like this.
Yeah, だからさ、そういうわけじゃないと言ってないけど、そんなことなくない？
あ、ないない。
And finally, why Japanese grammar is actually kind of dope. One word, abbreviation. For example,
私はそれをやります.
I'm going to do that can be contracted to simply yaru. This literally translates to do. This is a grammatically correct sentence. Whereas in English, you'd have to at least say, I'll do that. Or you risk sounding like a caveman. This makes Japanese extremely fun to play around with and very low effort to speak.
Konbini iku?
Iku.
Kaoru wa?
Iku.
What up, TV crew? Thanks for watching my video. If you made it this far, don't forget to clickety-clack that like button, leave a comment, and subscribe. It all helps convince YouTube to recommend my video to more people. And I'm still super new to making videos, so if you had any feedback about the format, the talking style, or anything, I'd love to hear it. That's all for now. I'll see you guys in the next one.